You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Sunday, the 3rd of July, 2022, 14th Sunday in ordinary time. And today we have an encouraging word. The word that reminds us that God has not abandoned us. He will comfort us in our distress. And in order to do that, he will send people to give us that comfort. And that sending is found in the gospel passage of today. Participating in the proclamation of the word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Angela Tamko from Yaounde, Cameroon, who celebrated her birthday on the 1st of this month on Friday, text for us the first reading. Teresa Jamba from Oshikango, Namibia, who also celebrated her birthday on Friday, text for us the responsorial psalm. Judith Tabita from Wuppertal, Germany, text for us the second reading. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Stephen Kweku Daniels from Takoradi Diocese in Ghana as he celebrates his birthday today. Let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. Beyond, I will extend prosperity to her like a river. A reading from the book of Isaiah. Isaiah 66, 10-14c. Rejoice with Jerusalem and be glad for her, all who love her. Rejoice with her in joy, all you who mourn over her, that you may suck and be satisfied with her consoling breasts, that you may drink deeply with delight from the abundance of her glory. For thus says the Lord, behold, I will extend prosperity to her like a river, and the wealth of the nations like an overflowing stream. And you shall suck, you shall be carried upon her hip and fondled upon her knees. As one whom his mother comforts, so I will comfort you. You shall be comforted in Jerusalem. You shall see, and your heart shall rejoice. Your bones shall flourish like the grass, and it shall be known that the hand of the Lord is with his servants. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, taken from Psalm 66, verse 1 to 3, 4 to 5, 6 to 7, 16 and 20. Response is taken from Psalm 66, verse 1. And the response is, cry out with joy to God, all the earth. Cry out with joy to God, all the earth. O sing to the glory of his name. O render him glorious praise. Say to God, how awesome your deeds. Cry out with joy to God, all the earth. Before you, all the earth shall bow down, shall sing to you. Sing to your name. Come and see the works of God, awesome his deeds among the children of men. Cry out with joy to God, all the earth. He turned the sea into dry land, They passed through the river on foot. Let our joy then be in him. He rules forever by his might. Cry out with joy to God, all the earth. Come and hear, all who fear God. I will tell what he did for my soul. Blessed be God, who did not reject my prayer, nor withhold from me his merciful love. Cry out with joy to God, all the earth.
Second reading. I bear on my body the marks of Jesus. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Galatians chapter 6, verse 14 to 18. Brethren, far be it from me to glory, except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by which the world has been crucified to me, and I to the world. For neither circumcision counts for anything, nor uncircumcision, but a new creation. Peace and mercy be upon all who walk by this rule, upon the Israel of God. Henceforth, let no man trouble me, for I bear on my body the marks of Jesus. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit, brethren. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 10, verse 1 to 12. Continue from verses 17 to 20. At that time, the Lord appointed 70 others and sent them on ahead of him, two by two, into every town and place where he himself was about to come. And he said to them, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Pray therefore the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. Go your way. Behold, I send you out as lambs in the midst of the wolves. Carry no purse, no bag, no sandals, and salute no one on the road. Whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace be to this house.' And if a son of peace is there, your peace shall rest upon him. But if not, it shall return to you. And remain in the same house, eating and drinking what they provide, for the laborer deserves his wages. Do not go from house to house. Whenever you enter a town and they receive you, eat what is set before you. Heal the sick in it and say to them, 'The kingdom of God has come near to you.' But whenever you enter a town and they do not receive you, go into its street and say, 'Even the dust of your town that clings to our feet, we wipe off against you.' Nevertheless, now this, that the kingdom of God has come near, I tell you, it shall be more tolerable on that day for Sodom than for that town." The 70 returned with joy, saying, "Lord, even the demons are subject to us in your name." And he said to them, "I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. Behold, I have given you authority to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall hurt you. Nevertheless, do not rejoice in this, that the spirits are subject to you, but rejoice that your names are written in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us begin with the first reading of today so that we connect it to the Gospel passage for us to understand the message of today. The people of Israel had come back from exile in 537 BC, and they came to Jerusalem expecting to find everything in place, because that was the promise of the prophets. Ezekiel promised that God was going to gather all the people from all over and bring them to their own land, and they shall enjoy life there. Ezekiel had gone with the people in exile, and God, through Ezekiel, had made a lot of promises of how God was going to restore things for the people despite their unfaithfulness. Even other prophets like Isaiah, could the Lord ever leave you? Could the Lord ever forget her children? Even if the mother may forget her suckling child, I will never forget you. That is the promise of the Lord in Isaiah chapter 49, verse 14 to 16. The Lord has forsaken me, says Zion, and my Lord has forgotten me. Can a woman forget a nursing child and not have compassion on the son of her womb? Surely they may forget, yet I will not forget you. See, I have inscribed you on the palms of my hands. Your words are continually before me. That is my promise, and I will never change. You may change, but my love for you is constant. Jeremiah chapter 31, verse 3. And now they came back to the land, and things hadn't improved at all. People found there was no land. People found still things were not as they expected them to be. Some of them became even servants, slaves of those who had remained there and settled. Now, third Isaiah came with the word of encouragement to let them know God has not stopped restoration. He's still the mother, and he wants to make Jerusalem the mother for the people of Israel. And this people of Israel, after their exile experience, had learned that God is not just the God of Israel, he's the God of the whole universe, he's the God of everyone who believes in him. And so they had become open-minded. Their exile experience had made them understand that God operates in everyone. And so here we see something working out here. The people now understand that this mother, Jerusalem, is for everyone. And people have to also breastfeed from this mother, Jerusalem. The Lord promises that this is what he's going to do. As one whom his mother comforts, so I will comfort you. You shall be comforted in Jerusalem. You shall see, and your heart shall rejoice, and your bones shall flourish like the grass. And the hand of the Lord shall be known to his servants. That's a promise. That, listen, you may feel dejected. You may feel like things are not moving. Nothing is working out in your life. I am going to make sure that something starts working out. He is going to make us feed from Jerusalem, which represents the presence of the peace of God in our lives. He's going to make sure that all of us are breastfed. And that breastfeeding was going to be the presence of God's word among the people, who are going to be breastfed by the word of God. The milk was going to be that word of God which was going to feed the people again, and the people would now rejoice in the fact that God is again among them. And that is fulfilled 500 years later with the coming of Christ. Christ, whose coming was not just meant for the Jews, but for everyone. This had to be clarified in the Gospel of Luke. The Gospel of Luke gives us two sendings, two missions of the apostles. One was the mission of the 12. He sent the 12, and after this, he sent 70 others, Some other scripts say 72 others based on Genesis chapter 10, which gives us the table of the nations. They believed there were 72 nations. And so the Lord sending 72 others gives us this understanding that the mission of Christ is meant for the whole world. It is not limited to Europe that received the newsletter also. It is not limited to America. It is not limited to only Egypt. It is not limited to only Australia. It is for the whole world, Africa included. Those of you who think that Christianity is a foreign religion, you have to rethink and understand that indeed Christianity is the most universal of all religions. It was meant to expand to the rest of the world from the very beginning. We find this in scripture. He sent the 72 others. And the number 72 represents the whole world. It is to the whole world that the word is to be proclaimed. It should not leave out any part of the world. So you have to understand that our mission is bigger than we have thought it to be. Christianity is not a localized religion. It is a universal religion. It is a religion for the whole world, because Catholic means universal. And Jesus himself made it universal by sending the 72. And you know what he did? He sent them to places where he himself was about to go. And who had to go before him? The messengers, the apostles. Jesus will never come before we go. We are the ambassadors for Christ, and we are the ones who make Christ come into the lives of other people. Because when we preach the word, when we share our mission and get involved in acts of charity, we are making Christ be present in the lives of people. So listen, understand this. There will be no miraculous coming of Christ in other people's lives if we don't take it up as our responsibility to make Christ reach there. We are ambassadors for Christ, and Christ comes to other people through the word that is preached to them. So we must be vigorous about that. So we must not relax. We want Christ to come in the lives of so many people who are discouraged. We want Christ to come in the lives of people who are in need of the mercy and love of God. And we want him to come in the land where hatred has taken over. We want him to come to a land where people have no respect for life. We want him to come to a land where people don't seem to value and respect their fellow human beings. We want him to come in those families where a sense of religion seems to have died, and men are doing whatever they want to do without respect for their spouses. Women are doing anything they want to do without respect for their spouses. We want Christ to come to such families. And he will only come when we relentlessly preach the word. As he was sending them, he warned them that he's sending them like lambs in the midst of wolves. Who are the wolves? Who are those dangerous animals? All injustices? All corrupt systems? All immorality? All sorts of things that are happening in the world today are the wolves. And we have to know how to handle those wolves. Jesus explains how to handle them. Carry no money, bag, no knapsack, no sandals. Why? Because he wants them to understand that the only way we are going to deal with those wolves is by not gaining our security from the things around us, but our security must come from God. Relying on God in our every need. Making God the reason why we do things and not for money. not for any gain, but in making sure that Christ is known in the world. And he tells them, please greet no one on the way. He's not telling you that we should stop greeting people. He understands the Jewish kind of greeting that makes you stop and then start asking about cows, start asking about what is happening in the family, the greeting that delays you. He says no, like the Hehes of Tanzania, they have a special way of greeting each other. They would start by greeting, how are you? And then they walk a bit and come back, how are the chickens? Then they walk a bit and come back and say, how are the cows and everything else you are keeping? So they start with human beings in the family. And then they come to the livestock. They ask about everything, even about your farm. Now, Jesus is saying, listen, this kind of greeting is not what I'm asking for. Because if you are to greet like this, you are going to delay the mission. He wants to emphasize the urgency of the mission. This is very important that we have to understand how urgent it is for us to make Christ known. Let us spread the good news on every social media platform. Let people come to know about Christ. It is urgent. It's no laughing matter. No, we must take seriously our evangelization and do it even on your status. If you don't use your status to spread the good news of Christ, then you are just busy greeting. There are people who just put on the status, I'm just here to say hi to you, all my fans. And we end there. We end with salutation. Salute no one on the way. Greet people after you have put something about the gospel, after you have put something that encourages people. Then you can put anything else on your status. Jesus says, greet no one on the way. And when you reach, and when you enter a house, let your first words be, peace be to this house, because that is exactly what you are taking there. You are not taking gossip in the families. You are not taking all the bad things to other people. You are taking peace. Check your evangelization. Some of you are evangelizers of gossip, of hatred, of tribalism, of racism, of religionism, what we call fanaticism. You are there trying to say all sorts of terrible things about other religions. And you leave discord, not peace, in the family you are sharing with. The Lord says, your words must be, peace be to this house. And if a man of peace lives there, that peace will remain in that house. This is what we are supposed to spread to others. We are supposed to make the world understand that the message of Christianity is peace, not war, not violence, not terrorism. Others may be there to destroy us, even wanting to kill us. We're not going to imitate them. We're not going to revenge. No, because the mission of Christianity is peace. Peace. Just like I know the mission of Islam. Islam, the word Islam, Salam, is peace. The name itself means peace. Not violence, not terrorism. All those who are involved in terrorism, I've not understood Islam. Islam means peace. Islam, Dar es Salaam, all these are referring to peace. Salam. Salam means peace. And we are there having one mission. We have one common mission as believers. We are supposed to spread the Salam, peace to people. And let somebody who sees you as a Christian, we have this something to share in common as Christians and Muslims. We share peace as our common mission. And even as we go around to spread the news of God, we are spreading peace. And Christ wants us to know that is exactly what we are meant to do. And as we preach, we are also supposed to do acts of charity. One of them is healing the sick where we go. We are not supposed to make people more sick than we found them by the things we talk about. Many of us make other people raise their BPs when we go to visit them. Why? Because we are not giving them good news. We are heralds of bad news. I want to say, Lord, help us. Help us to be heralds of good news to the world. Help us to make the world a better world to live in. We are not going to plant discord. We are going to plant peace. And we want you, when you come, to indeed find a place prepared for you, to just find Salem. We want you to find Salem, peace, and not discord. There are the 70 returned, and they shared with Jesus what they saw. Oh Lord, even demons were obeying us. How can demons not obey you when you are sharing peace? A demon is a divided creature. A demon wants to divide. Wherever a demon is, there is division. So if you are a child of peace, a demon will have no place in you. It will obey you. And so they returned and said, Lord, even the demons are subject to us in your name. And he says, yes, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. Behold, I have given you authority to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall hurt you. Don't try it. Don't go and step on that cobra. That's not what Jesus is referring to. You have to understand the language here. The serpent represented the evil forces. Serpents and scorpions represented the evil forces, because the evil forces just bite. They bite you even when you are not aware. You don't see them. By the time you are seeing them, you are already beaten. And you know what? We have so many evil forces around us. Some of those evil forces, we are living with them. But if you are firmly founded in your faith, you will live with scorpions and snakes. Those serpents, you will not be hurt. Your character is not going to be influenced. You are going to live with the corrupt. You will never be corrupt. You are going to live with the promiscuous. You will never be promiscuous. You are going to live with the prostitutes. You are not going to get into that business. Why? Because you have firm founded. That is exactly what the Lord is trying to say today. He wants to say, you may be in the company of drunkards. You'll be safe. You will not become one of them. You're going to be in the company of witches and wizards. You will not be one of them. They will become like you, a believer. You're going to change those scorpions. You're going to change those snakes. That draw is what you have. And I know you are going to achieve it as you continue spreading the message of Christ. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Sunday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I is my daily God.